Hi there, my name is Nils with Learn to DIY, and I've been wondering whether or not a 3D printed saw blade can cut through a piece of wood. Let's find out. I'm gonna try 5 different blade variations, all with varying tooth counts and thicknesses for this test, and I've also prepared several types of materials for them to cut through. Now our first blade today is super thin. This is 0.73 millimeters, so less than 1 millimeter thick, and it's also completely round. There are no teeth whatsoever on this blade. As we try it with the paper, it seems to run through it just fine. No problems there. Next up, we have the double ply cardboard, which with a bit of patience, it also cuts in half, but I'm starting to see little bits of plastic flying around. It looks like the blade is being eaten up by the cardboard there. Next is a 3 millimeter thick piece of plywood. Now plywood is generally harder on saw blades than solid wood, especially softer woods, but at 3 millimeters, let's see what it can do. Now we're really starting to see some damage to the blade. It barely makes it, but it does cut through. Not bad. Our next material is 1/4 inch thick pine. This is a softer wood. It's the stuff that 2x4s are made out of. And right away we're starting to see some melting and gooping here. And I just don't know if it's gonna make it, so I start pushing a bit harder on it to see what happens. It's wobbling all over the place. And we seem to have created a bit of a 3D printed toothpaste factory here. It's just melting like butter. Check it out, you can actually see the diameter of the blade shrinking as I push through here. Now for a bit of a torture test, I'm really just trying to break the blade at this point. And this one is done for. Part of the blade is still intact, while the rest has shattered and broken apart. This one has definitely failed. Next up, we'll try the same blade, but this time with 180 tiny teeth on it. The paper is already way easier to cut with this. Cardboard too, not a problem for this blade. With that 3 millimeter plywood, we're seeing some major damage to the blade. Lots of broken teeth, but can it finish the job? Yes, but it's not fast and the blade is looking pretty bad. So now we move on to the 1/4 inch pine and it's really struggling here. Whoa! Okay, we have serious breakage on the blade, so we got chunks flying all over, so I decided to go in for the kill. And with that, there goes the last bit and this blade is done for. There's not much left of this blade, and it actually did worse on the 1/4 inch pine test than the circle. This little shard is really all that's left of this blade. Okay, next up is a slightly thicker piece, this one coming in at 1 millimeter, but it only has 40 teeth. For the paper, this was actually the easiest cut yet. Cardboard was also a breeze, especially once the blade stabilized a bit. Now for the plywood, it definitely started doing some damage. There were bits of saw blade all over the place, but it was cutting. It's kind of hard to see here, but it is making its way through the wood now, and it's all the way through. Now, for the 1/4 inch pine, the blade is dying a quick death, shrinking by the second. And now we're seeing pools of PLA gathering on the pine, and it is over as quickly as it began. Now, our second to last contestant is the 180 tooth blade, but this time 1.6 millimeters thick, much thicker than before. The paper is a cakewalk for this, it just buzzes right through it. 2 sheets of paper, no problem. And it can't even feel the cardboard, but I do think I'm seeing little bits of plastic flying around. Now for the plywood. This is not going well. The plywood just murdered that blade, and now we're getting gobs of PLA, but with some persistence, this weak little blade does make it through. The blade has no chance against the pine, so let's just wear it down a bit. The 10-inch blade with 180 teeth that we started with is now a 9-inch blade with no teeth. And now it's time to call in the big dog. This is the Green Machine. This thing is 4 millimeters thick and it has 40 teeth and this thing is pretty sturdy. Now just like with the last blade, the plywood is getting cut, but it's doing some serious damage. Lots of tooth breakage going on here. By the time we start on the pine, the teeth are halfway gone, and they have no edge to them anymore. This stuff is so thick, it's just melting everywhere now. So it takes on the consistency of chewed gum, and it's all stretching and pulling, and that blade is disappearing in a hurry, making a total mess. Check out some of the carnage from this green machine. I mean, this thing melted so easily and created all kinds of wacky and weird shapes from the melted PLA. Now, if you enjoyed this kind of video, you're definitely gonna wanna check out my 3D printed bulletproof Stormtrooper, where we actually took it to a range, shot it full of lead, and you'll just have to watch it to see what happens. I'm Nils, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.